Hey YouTube golf fans, Herman Williams here with HermanWilliamsGolf.com. A little shorter video today, just kind of a quick tip. I've done a lot of videos about how to avoid coming over the top, done videos about how to create lag in the swing, but I still get tons of questions about both of those concepts. Thought I'd give you just a little extra tip to go with a couple of the videos that we already have out there. Just a quick reminder, if you haven't seen those videos, let me get rid of this stick here for a second. But we've kind of talked to you about the fact that as you get to the top of a backswing, the typical person that's going to come over the top has probably listened too much to what the tour talks about doing, where the downswing is going to start with hip clearing. If you're not as flexible as a tour player, maybe not as gifted, maybe don't have the range of movement, generally as soon as you begin to turn your hips, you're actually going to sit back on the back foot as you do it. It's going to cause your shoulders to come forward, arms to go with that. Golf club comes screaming over the top. Now you're going to cut across the golf ball and hit that weak slice, maybe plow in and hit it fat. I mean, it's just shank the ball. There's just so many combinations of bad results there. When we watch what the tour players do, and potentially it's just because they're a little bit more flexible, but as they arrive at the top of the swing, they understand that they have to keep the chest and upper body closed as their downswing starts. Now, if you're gifted enough to begin turning your hips as your chest stays closed to the target, then you can do that. But most of us find that pretty difficult. So as we'd arrive at the top and start the downswing, we recommend that you shift or literally back into the target. It'll feel like your rear end and your back stay facing the target. They move targetward as the arms drop down. But we still, in spite of that advice, see a lot of people struggle with it. So I've got an extra tip for you today that may help you a little bit with that. I'll pick my plane stick back up here. I'm going to set it just right across the front of my shoulders like so. And I'm going to kind of simulate a backswing here. Of course, you can do this with a golf club. Just cross your hands here right in front of your shoulders. Pin it to the tops of the shoulders. Get in a golf posture and make this backswing wind up. Now, I'd want you to see that the typical player that comes over the top from here immediately begins to unwind. The hips start to go. They don't have enough flexibility, and the shoulders go with it. So now this right shoulder is beginning to go forward as the left shoulder peels out to the left. My hands will go with it. The golf club will go. The momentum builds up, cut across the golf ball. And to add insult to injury, once it gets that far outside and you're coming into impact, the arms will shorten up and pull across the ball. A lot of times we toe it, thin it, a variety of things. So we come back to our windup right in this position here. Here's the move I want you to start. We know we'd like to back into the target. We know we want to get that lateral hip shift, but we still see people that are trying to feel that fail and come around. I want you to try a new move with your shoulders. As you start your downswing, let the left shoulder go up. You can see how my plane stick is going up in the air. My right shoulder is going down. And notice that the stick is actually still pointed to right field. It is not opened up whatsoever. And in case the stick doesn't show up clearly enough, I'll get the golf club back up in the air here. And I want you to see, I make my wind up, normal shoulder turn. I start down, and I can do this rapidly, launch right into a move that looks like I'm going to hit a golf shot. Notice how my chest is technically still facing where my golf ball would be on the ground. It is not opened up. And if I do it rapidly, you can actually see that I've kept my shoulder slightly closed, kept the right shoulder inside the left, and now this grip is pointed off a little bit to right field. If I do it with a golf club in my hand, it just gets me dropped right in the slot really quickly. This might even be too much. That ball would probably be hit too much from the inside. But if you've been an over-the-top player, we don't mind exaggerating that. So give that a shot. I mean, we've got other videos out there that you can study, how to back into the target, how to shift, how to drop the arms. We've got one where we talk about laying the club on the table behind you. But this little shoulder move might be the thing that would seal the deal for you. Get those arms down into the hitting area where you can really start to fire through on the release. Anyway, I hope that will help you out. I'm Herman Williams for Herman Williams Golf, and you've just been Hermanized.